हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू भोलानाथ एकेडमी। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू सी द केमिकल रिएक्शन ऑफ ईस्टर। स्टूडेंट्स, हियर वी आर यूजिंग वेरी सिंपल ईस्टर स्टूडेंट, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इथाइल एसीटेट। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर हैविंग द इथाइल एसीटेट। नाउ हाउ द इथाइल एसीटेट इज गोइंग टू बी रिएक्ट विद द डिफरेंट कंपाउंड्स। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट हैपेंड, यू हैव नाउ ईस्टर इन योर टेस्ट ट्यूब एंड यू आर एडिंग डिफरेंट मटेरियल। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, फर्स्ट ईस्टर स्टूडेंट्स, वेरी सिंपल ईस्टर आई एम टेकिंग हियर, दैट इज इथाइल एसीटेट। तो फर्स्ट आई एम राइटिंग एसीटेट CH3COOC2H5, दिस इज इथाइल एसीटेट, सिंपल ईस्टर स्टूडेंट्स। नाउ यू हैव द ईस्टर इन योर हैंड and you are reacting with dilute HCl. First reaction of ester, we are going to react with dilute HCl. So this is ethyl acetate, because this is acetate group and this is ethyl, so we call it ethyl acetate. You are knowing this, students. Now what happens, students, when you add dilute HCl? What happens when you are going to be add dilute HCl? In presence of, students, you have to heat this solution. What happens, students, there is a, because we have used acid, that is called as acid hydrolysis will takes place. Acid hydrolysis will occur here. Now what happens, students, when the hydrolysis will takes place, there is a formation of ethyl alcohol C2H5OH. There is a formation of alcohol and this ethyl acetate will break and form CH3COOH, that is you are getting acetic acid and alcohol. That means ester will break in presence of dilute HCl and you will get two product, that is acetic acid and alcohol. Acetic acid and alcohol you are getting, students, if you have ester. This way ester will break and will form acetic acid and ethyl, because you dilute HCl. That means here you have to dissolve HCl in water. Now what happens, students? Now second, you have ester, now you are going to react with base. Now simple, students, ester we have taken here, that is ethyl acetate CH3COOC2H5. This is acetate group, students. We are writing what? Ethyl acetate. This is ethyl acetate. Simple ester, students. Now you have ester in the test tube and you are adding dilute NaOH. NaOH when dissolved in water we call as dilute NaOH. Now again, students, what happens, students? Here you have to heat. Now here hydrolysis will take place, but in presence of alkali. We call as alkali hydrolysis. This is called as what? Alkali hydrolysis, which is very important, students. So far we have seen acid hydrolysis, now we are looking here alkali hydrolysis. What happens, students? You will get in alkali, first you are getting salt, that is sodium salt of acid, you are getting CH3CONa. That means you are getting sodium salt of acid. Now again you have to add dilute acid again, students, because what happens, there is acidification reaction will take place, students. There is a formation of acid. Acid formation will take place. That is why this reaction. Second reaction is also called as acidification reaction. Which type of acid, students, you are getting here? You are getting acetic acid CH3COOH. And there is a formation of sodium chloride. So you are getting acetic acid as a product. That means acid will break and form acetic acid and NaCl. Yeah, acetic acid is very important, students. If you want only acetic acid, you have to add alkali hydrolysis. Now, students, third reactions of ester we are going to see, that is very important, students. Here we are using Grignard reagent, ethyl magnesium halide. So for third reaction, students, CH3 ester, students, simplest ester we are taking, this is acetate and here we are adding ethyl. So name of ester is ethyl acetate. This is acetate, students. So ethyl acetate ester you have in the test tube and you are adding, students, what? Methyl magnesium iodide. You are adding what? Methyl magnesium iodide in presence of ether as a solvent. After adding this, students, you have to do again, you have to add dilute HCl. That means HCl you are adding in water, dilute HCl. Then you have to third, what activity you have to do? You have to heat it, students. Heating is required. Without heating the product will not form. So this ethyl acetate, students, what happens? First it will form the acetone, students, CH3COCH3. Again, students, you have to do the, you have to add methyl magnesium iodide in presence of ether. Again, you have to do the reaction. Again, you have to add dilute HCl. You have to dissolve the HCl in water. And what happens, students? This acetone will convert into tertiary butyl alcohol. That means here, students, this methyl group is go on adding in the reaction. You are getting the double bond will become single bond. CH3, and here alcohol group will attach. We call as what? This is called as tertiary butyl alcohol. So here students, we are getting tertiary. We want to prepare tertiary butyl from step. This way you have to prepare the tertiary butyl alcohol. So these are the conversion of ethyl acetate into tertiary butyl alcohol. Thank you very much, students. If you like my video, please share it.